What's up? Welcome to the courtroom.
I am Cleo.
And I'm Oj. And in this podcast, we tell stories about people's life, liberty, and property.
Kikwentohan namin kayo about court rulings in a way that will make you understand jurisprudence like a 9-year-old.
All persons before the court, Supreme Court of Justice, just hear the message for the court.
So join us as we delve into true crime, political controversies, and all things tare de chismis every week.
In the first week of November 1999, Christian Frederick Harper, a 30-year-old business development manager of an engineering firm, came to Manila on a business trip. He went to Shangri-La Hotel and checked in at room 1428.
His departure was supposed to be on November 6, but he wasn't able to check out of the hotel alive. Christian was found murdered and stabbed to death inside his room ng mga di pa nakikilalang suspect.
Teka, start tayo. Paano ba na-discover yung murder?
Ganto kasi yan. Around 11 a.m. of November 6, 1999, may isang Caucasian na lalaki, about 30 to 32 years old, 5'4 ang height at nakasuot ng maroon na long sleeves, black denim pants at itim na sapatos ang pumunta sa Alexis Jewelry Store in Glorieta. Gusto daw niyang bilhin yung Cartier na ladies watch worth 320,000.
Balak sana nung guy na gamitin yung MasterCard at American Express credit cards na nakapangalan kay Christian Harper. But yung sales lady at Alexis Jewelry, si Annalisa Lumba, finds the customer suspicious kasi di niya masagot yung mga tanong ng credit card representatives over the phone.
Ang ginawa ni Annalisa, she asked for the passport of the customer and as suggested by the credit card representative, she put the card on hold. Siguro probably sensing trouble for himself, dali-daling umalis yung customer sa store. In fact, naiwan pa nga niya yung credit card and yung passport ni Christian Harper.
Siyempre, in-inform yung family niya sa Norway about the incident. Christian's family attempted to call him at his hotel room. But since they are not getting any response from the room, ni-request nila na i-check yung kwarto.
Raymond Alarcon, the duty manager of Shangri-La Hotel, and a security personnel went to room 1428 at 11:27 a.m. and were shocked to discover Christian's lifeless body on the bed.
The hotel security manager, Colonel Rodrigo de Guzman, initially investigated the murder and concluded that Christian got drunk with his visitors in his room the night before dahil sa mga empty bottles of wine sa trash can and mga cigarette butts.
Dumating naman sa hotel ang team ni PO3 Carmelito Mendoza and SPO4 Roberto Hison to conduct police investigation. Nakita nila ang katawan ni Christian na nasa kama at nakabalot sa isang blanket. Nung tinaas nila yung blanket, they saw that Christian's eyes and mouth had been bound with electrical and packaging tapes. And yung hands and feet niya are tied with a rope.
The police then checked the CCTV footage and found that Christian entered his room at 12:14 a.m. on November 6. Sinundan siya ng isang babae sa kanyang kwarto at 12:17 a.m. Then, a Caucasian man entered the room at 2:48 a.m. Umalis yung girl at around 5:33 a.m. and yung Caucasian man at 5:46 a.m.
Kinumpirma naman ni Annalisa na yung Caucasian man nga sa CCTV is yung same man na nagtangkang bumili dun sa jewelry store nila gamit yung credit card and passport ni Christian.
On August 30, 2002, nagsampa ng kaso yung family ni Christian sa Regional Trial Court to recover damages from Makati Shangri-La, alleging that the murderer succeeded to trespass into the room of Christian on account of the hotel's gross negligence.
Their failure daw to provide the most basic security system to its guests and the acts or omission of its employees was the immediate cause of the tragic death of Christian.
The RTC of Quezon City ruled in favor of the Harpers, holding the owner and operator of the 5-star Shangri-La Hotel in Makati City liable for damages for the murder of Christian. And the Court of Appeals affirmed the decision.
Now, Shangri-La 6 for the review of the CA's judgment.
Bakit? Ano bang issue dito?
Well, dalawang tanong or issue na sasagutin ng Supreme Court dito. Firstly, if yung respondents in this case, which claims to be the wife and the son of Christian, were able to establish their legal relationship with the victim.
And secondly, was Christian's untimely demise brought upon by his own negligence or is it by the hotels?
Okay, so punta tayo sa first issue. Bakit may issue ng legal relationship? Hindi ba dapat as easy as mapakita mo lang yung marriage certificate mo or in case of filiation, birth certificate lang, enough proof na to establish that they are the real family and heirs?
Well, ganun lang sana kadali if they are Filipino nationals. Kasi andito lang naman sa Philippines yung mga public documents natin. Kaso, yung victim sa case na to is a Norwegian national. So, iba ang process of authentication. Sabi kasi ng Shangri-La, pursuant to the best evidence rule, hindi daw uubra yung mga documentary evidence ng mga Harpers.
Ano bang mga pieces of evidence ang sinubmit sa case na to?
The Harper submitted the birth certificate of the victim, Christian Frederick Harper. His marriage certificate to his wife, Ellen. The birth certificate of Jonathan Christopher Harper, yung son nila. And a certificate from the Oslo Probate Court that Ellen was married to the victim. And that she and their son were the recognized heirs of the deceased.
Anong naging issue sa documents na to? Nakapag-submit naman pala ng birth certificate and marriage certificate.
Well, kaso lang, yung marriage certificate daw is a mere translation of the original copy. So, inadmissible daw yon. Plus, yung mga documents were not duly attested by legal custodians.
Well, sino ba dapat ang mag-a-attest sa mga gantong documents?
Yung sa marriage certificate, dapat yung vicar of the parish of Allern in Norway. Kasi sila din yung nag-issue ng document eh. Then, yung sa probate court certificate, dapat i-attest ng judge of the probate court. Since the documents were not duly attested by the legal custodians, there is a clear violation daw, as per Shangri-La, of Section 24 and 25 of Rule 132 of the Revised Rules of Court, or yung tinatawag na hearsay rule.
Well, yan ang argument ng kampo ng Shangri-La. Ano namang sabi ng Supreme Court?
As per the court, the pieces of evidence showed clear and competent proof naman that they are the victim's widow and son. Hence, entitled sila sa damages.
Pero kala ko kulang sa attestation, so baliwala na lang yun.
Di naman sa baliwala, but hindi din naman kasi totally devoid of authentication yung document.
Well, sabagay, that's right. Kasi diba, the documents involved in this case were all kept in Norway. And while yes, they are translation, it was translated and authenticated by the Royal Norwegian Ministry of Foreign Affairs. The documents are accompanied by the authentication by the consul, the embassy of the Republic of the Philippines in Stockholm, Sweden. And to that effect, Tanya Sorli from the Royal Ministry of Foreign Affairs Oslo is deemed authorized to legalize the official documents and those documents should be treated with validity.
The court stressed that while they are not excused from complying with our rules, the court should consider the realities of litigating this case overseas. Siyempre, taga Norway yung mga Harpers and given na ang daming kailangan daanan just to have a document authenticated. But despite that, they were able to comply with all processes. Kaya naman, the Supreme Court deemed that there is every reason for a relaxed application of the rules regarding the issuance of the required attestation from the custodian of the documents.
With regards naman sa filiation ng anak ni Harper, di ba sabi sa Article 172 of the Family Code, the filiation of the legitimate children shall be proved by any other means allowed by the rules of court and special laws.
Okay, so anong meron dito?
Wala, na-share ko lang. Char. Di ba kasi sabi ng court na, na-present naman daw nila yung birth certificate ni Jonathan, yung anak ng biktima at ni Ellen. Since those documents are presumably public documents naman sa Norway, then such evidence sufficiently established the relationship and filiation of Ellen and Jonathan dun sa biktimang si Christian.
So, settled na yung first issue. Second issue naman, sino ba talagang negligent sa kasong to? Yung Shangri-La ba o yung victim, si Christian?
Well, the court ruled that Makati Shangri-La is liable for negligence.
Kasi diba, bilang hotel, lalo na 5-star hotel pa sila, yung tinatawag na reasonable care that the hotel must exercise for the safety and comfort of its guests should be commensurate dun sa quality of the accommodation it offers.
That's right. The court reiterate that when one registered as a guest of the hotel, he makes the establishment the guardian of his life and his personal belongings during his stay.
According sa findings ng trial court, the negligence stems down to Shangri-La's inadequate hotel security. More particularly, dun sa failure daw ng hotel to deploy sufficient security personnel.
Actually, mismong si Colonel De Guzman, yung chief security officer ng Shang, ang nag-testify na talagang kulang ang roving guards nila. Sabi pa ni Colonel De Guzman, he even recommended pa nga daw na dahil nga L-shape yung hallway, at least dapat one guard per floor yung mag-cover ng hallway.
So it could be inferred from the testimony of Shang's security officer na talagang naging negligent sila in providing adequate security. Such negligence is the proximate cause which set the chain of events that led to the eventual demise of Christian Harper. Kasi daw, had there been reasonable security precautions, the same could have saved Christian Harper from a brutal death.
In the end, the Supreme Court enunciated na ang hotel business, like common carriers business, is imbued with public interest. Catering to the public, hotel keepers are bound to provide not only lodging for the hotel guest, but also security to their persons and belongings. Those are the twin duty constituting the essence of the hospitality or hotel business.
Kaya naman, the Supreme Court entirely concurred with the finding and conclusion of the Court of Appeals and orders Shangri-La to pay the cost of suit to the heirs of Christian Harper.
If you guys like this audiogram, please listen to the full episode on Spotify or on your favorite podcast app where you can hear our insights on this case. Again, this is Oj.
And Teo, leaving you with a reminder to always look back in history because precedent shall rule the future.
Thank you for listening and we'll see you again in the courtroom.